So moving on to the next portion, part of this one, refraction at this other surface. First we finished the refraction at ABC curved surface, correct? We have arrived at an equation and I will name that equation as equation number 1. Now, in the refraction of ADC, we are considering this light ray to be coming from outer space, somewhere, randomly. We are not considering this point P at all. Because this surface we are not considering. Imagining that only this surface is present, there is a light ray coming and falling at point Q on the surface ADC. Okay, the light ray will come and fall at this one from the refractive index N2 to the refractive index N1. Yeah? So from the lens to the outer world atmosphere. So now what happens, the light ray coming from the denser medium to rarer medium, it will bend away from the normal. Normal is this line. Okay, so this is Q line, Q to C, this is this one. It bend away from the normal line, reach out to this point and form an image at I. This is the image formation at I. This is where the actual image is formed. Now, we don't know the source from where it is coming from. So what I am going to do here is, I will extend this such a way that it has not undergone any refraction. I will extend the same light ray in such a way that it falls on the principal axis of the same thing. And this is where my virtual image will be present. I1. I will call that virtual image position as I1. And that is the source which is causing this particular light ray to come from. Okay, this is the source of this origin of light. So, this will be the object distance that I am considering that as V1. This will be the source, that's why source distance means object distance is V1. This is the image distance V. Okay, and this is the radius of curvature R. So using these topic, I will substitute in my general formula of lens that this will be over here as the first one N1 will be entering from N2, right? So it will be N2 divided by image distance is V1. Carefully while substituting, don't get confused. N1 by V itself is equal to N1 minus N2, the second refractive index minus the first refractive index, divided by R2. Okay? Now looking at this equation and this equation, I want to make a relation between these two surfaces, that is ABC and ABC. So I will add these two equations, but before adding, this is N2 minus N1, this is N1 minus N2. I will interchange their position so that something becomes common in the two equations for my calculation purpose. There is no other purpose other than that. So I am just going to keep it like that and interchange their positions as N2 minus N1. When I do that interchanging position, the negative signs comes outside. Simple mathematics. R2. And this is the equation which I am considering it to be as equation number 2. So now I will add the equation number 1 and 2. This equation and that equation I'm adding, the left hand side will look something like this, N1 divided by U plus N2 divided by V1 minus this plus this. The left hand side looks something like this, the right hand side, this N2 minus N1 divided by R1 minus N2 minus N1 divided by R2. That is how the addition will look like, and easily this thing cancels. Remaining will be, I'll write the first plus sign over here, N1 divided by E minus N1 divided by E. Okay, I'm just writing this first and then second this. So here N1, N2 minus N1, I take it outside common. Remaining will be 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Yeah, so right now in this side, I can take out N1 common. This will be 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1, 1 by R, 1 plus minus 1 by R. So here, dividing the left hand side and right hand side by N1, the left hand side N1 will be cancelled and only thing remaining will be 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 divided by N1 into 1 by R1 minus R2. This also equation, you can stop it at that, or also I can continue it further and write it like this, 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to N2 by N1 minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Okay, so now to simplify this equation, I come to the reality saying that the image will always, or sorry, the object is always originated at the infinity. That means very far away. We don't know the exact position of that object. So we consider that the object is placed at infinity, which means the object distance is equal to infinity. That is what I am trying to tell. The image should be formed at the focus point so that we can see it. So which means any lens should form the image at the focus point itself. Any meaningful lens. If we are using this concave lens, this what it does, this is helping us to form the image at the retina, and retina is nothing but a focus. So image should be formed at the focus point, and that which means the image distance should be focus, focal length. Correct or not? Image distance should be focal length. So which means I will substitute these corresponding values. V is f. Okay, in this equation, if I put these two values, V is f minus 1 by infinity is equal to n2 by n1 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by this 1 by infinity is 0, so I just erase this out. So the final equation will look something like this as 1 by f is equal to n1 by n2, sorry, n2 by n1 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So this is the final lens focus formula which you need to remember. Okay, so let me know if you have any doubts. Go through this video to clear the notes.